Hi everyone, I'm Charlene Habermeyer of Good Parenting Brighter Children, and this is Tidbits of Wisdom for Parents. Today we're going to talk about sodas, everybody's favorite drink. And I'm sure that you already know all the bad things about soda, and I'm just going to add a few other things to help you to make a decision that you either need to cut back on your sodas or cut them out entirely, and definitely you need to watch them with your children. There's a number of different studies and research that has been done about soda, mainly about the consumption of soda and how many cans of soda do people consume. Actually, the number is 56 gallons of soda per year per person. Now, this is an average because there's a lot of people out there who do not take, you know, they don't drink sodas, and so this is an average, and they said that teen boys drink 5 to 7 more cans of soda than their female counterparts. That's a lot of soda in a year, particularly because of what soda has in it. First of all, let's talk about phosphoric acid. Okay, the phosphoric acid in soda is similar to, in terms of acidity, it's about the same as vinegar. And so to combat that, they put in, for every 12-ounce can of soda, they put in 3.5 tablespoons of sugar, which is almost 1/4 cup of sugar. And you're probably thinking, well, 1/4 cup is pretty small. Well, go into your kitchen, get 1/4 cup, measure a sugar out of 1/4 cup, and then put it on a plate and have a great look at it. That's a lot of sugar per each can of soda. Some of you are thinking, well, I'll just drink diet soda. Well, diet soda actually is considered an excitotoxin, and there's a whole book about the dangers of excitotoxins. So no, if you're going to make a choice and if you are going to drink soda, then get the real thing with the real sugar in it and not the fake sugar. Okay, so the next problem that we have with soda, of course, and by the way, the phosphoric acid, it pulls both calcium and magnesium out of your bones. But the caffeine pulls even more calcium out of your bones. And I think, you know, you're probably thinking, well, if you're a coffee drinker and a soda drinker, then you are in deep trouble. But actually, there's more sugar and caffeine and everything in sodas than there is in coffee. So in terms of caffeine will pull out calcium out of your bones for 4 hours. It seeps out of your bones for 4 hours and passes through the urine. Now, a couple of things that happen with that. If you're getting low in calcium, then your skin is going to sag, number one. And the other thing about it is you are going to have problems with the modeling effect on your skin. All right, modeling effect, you can look it up on Amazon, or you can look it up on the internet. A modeling effect is a hyperpigmentation, but instead of, you know, usually with hyperpigmentation, it kind of forms a shape of some sort. Okay, this would be like if you were scribbling on a paper, that would be the shape of a modeling effect on your skin. So a lot of people don't want that, and you're probably thinking, well, I can get it lasered. Well, laser doesn't always help with the modeling because usually it goes down very deep, and so you laser the top of it, and then it just keeps coming up and coming up and coming up. That has to do with calcium being seeped from your bones because of the caffeine. There's another chemical in your body, and it's called adenosine, and it's a natural, it's actually a natural sleeping pill to help us go to sleep. Well, when you're taking soda and you're drinking, and the caffeine and the phosphoric acid actually block that, so you're not able to get to sleep. And if you're not able to get to sleep, then you're also going to have problems with your skin, not to mention your moods and how you feel and your health and your immune system. Okay, so caffeine is also linked to a number of different things, including cancer, bone loss, mental disorders, birth defects, chronic fatigue, dizziness, depression, allergies, behavioral disorders, and it also affects both the visual and the auditory areas of the brain. Okay, so we read that and we think, oh my gosh, you know, I've got to get off the sodas. If you're having a soda on occasion, or your kids are having a soda on occasion, maybe on the weekend, on Friday night, or whatever, you go out and get a hamburger, you get a soda, all right, that's no big deal. I'm mainly talking about kids who are drinking sodas every single day, who are going through 5 to 10 cans of soda every single day. Their parents are doing the same, that you can't make it through the day unless you go and get your big gulp. That's where the problems lie. And that's the problems that you're going, if you're going to continue, you will have problems with your health and happiness and well-being and your skin and everything else. So think about that. Now, some people say, okay, I'll give up the soda, but I'll stick with tea. Okay, green, black, and oolong tea are also very, very high in caffeine. So you need to look at that. Of course, the best alternative for anything in terms of drinking something would definitely be water. But people, unless you're really into health and wellness, people, you know, don't give a lot of credence to water, and we should, because it's amazing. It flushes out the system. It helps you in many different ways, and I've actually talked about water in the past. So think about this. Another thing that you should be aware of is that when trucks go out to clean up the roads, that if they, you know, if there's somebody out there that's been hurt or there's blood left on the highway, the thing that they use is Coca-Cola. If you want to get rid of the stains in your toilet, you put a can of Coca-Cola in there. And actually, they have to carry these men that go, you know, in the trucks, and if they're carrying Coke syrup, they have to carry cards that show that, you know, this is highly corrosive, because it is highly corrosive. So think about different things, and don't add fruit juices either. They're loaded with sugar. So you've got to think about something that you can replace it with, or in some way how you can eliminate most of it in your life. And good luck, because it's not easy, as we all know. Thank you for joining me, and I'll see you tomorrow.